All right, today we're tuning this 2300 Ford powered Jeep. All right, so this Jeep's got a 2300 Ford in it with this is a whole set HX30 Super, which I really don't know much about what that Super means, but seems to do okay. It's got a Beauport, it's their stage 3 cylinder head as far as porting goes with their 2.1 camshaft in it. It's still on pump gas. It's got a Stinger, like their pimp ECU, and then it's got a Stinger header on it as well. She's pretty gnarly suspension wise. I know that they built a lot of this stuff. There's a couple of them, him and a buddy, and they're both built fairly similarly. I think these guys just play around on like a farm with these or something, do some trail riding with them. Not sure if they ever see, you know, sand dune style stuff. Obviously we've got the Dyno rear tire set up on it, but kind of a neat deal. I wouldn't, kind of four-cylinder in an off-road Jeep thing's kind of different, but it works well for him. He's pretty happy with it. Check out the cage and the dash. This thing's, he's got the ECU. Obviously, he doesn't mount it there. It's hanging out for me to have easy access to it on the dyno. But I've actually never seen it with all four of the normal wheels and tires on it, but I'm sure that makes a pretty big difference in how it looks. But yeah, pretty cool thing. I don't know I can't remember what we've made with this before. We've had this thing on the dyno a couple times. Seems like it makes around 300 wheel. So the new change would be the cylinder head and camshaft. Previously it was on, I don't remember what cam was in it, but the head was stock. So I'd be curious to see how much power we pick up from that change. So I'm gonna just jump right into this thing and see what we can do with it. Okay, just got wrapped up with the Jeep. Made 302 foot-pounds of torque, 248 horsepower. The turbocharger is really too small, kind of having an issue controlling boost. I wasn't able to do pulls in. When I did a hit in fourth, the boost would go up like 9 pounds from the gear before. It's just definitely got a wastegate priority problem. And then it would fall. So we're gonna get that addressed and bring it back. I'm trying to talk him into putting a little bit bigger charger on it. But being the thing, you know, it's an off-road project, right? So it needs to spool fast. But all in all, pretty decent. I had said before that it would be cool to see what difference the cylinder head would make, but being that the turbocharger is too small, it's basically the cork in the end of the pipe is just too restrictive for us to really tell a difference with the camshaft and cylinder head change. So, but that's it for this one.